Hare Krishna. If conscience doesn't create a barrier between impulse and indulgence, intelligence must. Conscience refers to our innate sense of right and wrong. Conscience cautions us, warns us, it makes us feel bad that we should, when we start doing something which is wrong. So conscience is one of our inner protectors, and it protects by creating feelings of guilt, by creating a pinch within us when we do something wrong. Now sometimes in some people conscience may not be developed, or it may be deadened. That may be because they grew up in a culture where certain things were not considered wrong at all. So for example, in many cultures, meat eating might not be considered anything bad at all. Or say nowadays, looking at obscene images may not be considered wrong. So we may not feel anything with our intelligence, that something with our conscience, that it is wrong. So our conscience is sometimes not functioning properly. And at that time, that particular guard has been like sedated. So what do we do? So an impulse may come externally or even internally, in terms of we might get the urge to do something and we might just immediately indulge in it. So between impulse and indulgence, we need a barrier. We need a deterrent, something which will stop us from doing things, wrong things, succumbing unwanted indulgences. Now conscience is a healthy barrier, but if the conscience is not working, then we need another barrier, and that is intelligence. Even if we don't feel that something is wrong, but with our intelligence, we need to educate ourselves to understand how it is wrong. And only then we will be able to protect ourselves. So we need to look not just at the immediate pleasure, but look at its eventual consequence and understand how it is degrading, how it is entangling, how it is damaging for our life and well-being. So the Bhagavad Gita gives us this perspective when it declares in 5.22, Yehi samsparshaja bhoga dukkhayonaya evate adyantavantaha kaunteya nateshu ramate buddhaha. It says, Yehi samsparshaja bhoga, that in this world, whatever pleasures we enjoy by the contact of the senses with the sense objects, dukkhayonaya evate, they are the womb of misery. Adyantavantaha kaunteya. They have a beginning, they have an end. And after they end, then the trouble begins. Nateshu ramate buddhaha. That we have to be the wise, therefore do not indulge in such pleasures. So we have to use our intelligence, guided by scripture, guided by experience, guided by our reading, to note down what are the harmful consequences of a particular indulgence. And then we have to keep that ready with us. And then whenever the impulse strikes us, we will be able to look at our intelligence and defend ourselves with our intelligence and prevent an impulse from leading to indulgence. Of course, with our intelligence, we can't just keep fighting impulse. We also need to redirect ourselves towards transcendence, towards Krishna. So when we focus on something purposeful, then the impulse won't trouble us so much. But even to recognize that we shouldn't give in to the impulse and should redirect ourselves towards something purposeful, we need intelligence. So when conscience doesn't act as a barrier between impulse and indulgence, then our intelligence needs to act as a barrier. And we need to nourish our intelligence so that it will function as the barrier. Thank you. Hare Krishna.